Hi everyone, Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today we're going to talk about your mind's ear. A little bit of play on words here, but really, really important. Something I use constantly when I walk into a room. It has benefits and obviously has its downside too, because you're never really satisfied with what you hear. But what we're trying to develop in this video with your mind's ear is a mental definition or a reference of what good quality sound is, okay? What music should sound like to you? What music should sound like to you to give you that emotional connection? And there is a whole series of variables that must be satisfied. So let's look at some of the first ones. Low frequency attack and decay. First thing I notice when I come into a room is how the room handles the low frequency energy. You can hear it in just a heartbeat, a split second, one note. You can tell if the room is going to be able to manage the energy correctly. You can also tell if it's going to have the right attack and decay rates for low frequency energy. Most of the time you can hear the fundamental, it's the harmonics that get distorted. Usually not the opposite. So you have to really get a vision, a picture of this, a reference point in your mind for low frequency. So you have that to take with you every time you go into a room. Middle and high frequencies. Obviously, reverberation time is critical. Has the room measured? Has the room managed the reverberation time correctly? Is there a nice linear decay of the energy so that when one note fundamentally strikes in the room, it lives and dies on its own volition, naturally? So you have definition, you have separation, and you have focus. So that's the three variables that we need to have in the mid-range. Can you hear all of these in your head? Even though you're not playing music in your own room, are you able to take your room with you, if the room is your definition, and compare it to what you're listening to in the room you're currently residing in? You have to have a reference standard for comparison, because that will teach you what's right and wrong with your music in your room and other rooms that you go into. So you'll be able then with a reference to notice immediately what's missing. Okay, and then if you can define, quantify what's missing, then you can fix it. You can look at how to fix it, okay? And we have different ways we can do that. Two types of treatment, obviously, absorption and diffusion. And then we can start saying type, amount, and position of that treatment. We'll do a video on TAP later. But the goal here is to kind of get a mental vision, a picture of good quality sound, reference sound that you know of, and then carry that with you when you go into rooms. It'll help you learn about different room sizes and volumes and acoustics, and you'll be able to apply that to your own room and, you know, figure out what's missing. So when you walk into a room and you hear, oh, it's got great low end, how do you get that in my room? Or the middles and highs really have great definition and separation. How do I get that in my room? And you'll get that by having a reference. Thank you. Thank you for watching our videos. We really appreciate your support. And if you could give us a thumbs up for our Facebook page, that would really be helpful to us. Our room form gives us all the information about your room, length, width, height, usage, and we need you to fill that out before you send it in. Those of you that just found us on the internet and are under a time crunch, you can go to the contact section of our website and there's a book now button so you can book an appointment with us, but make sure I have your room form to go on with it. The ebook series that we have is free. Please subscribe to that. There's exclusive videos in there so you can get an idea of your particular situation, possibly with the videos. And then our forum. We have a forum on our website. There's a lot of forums out there on the internet. Our forum will actually answer your questions and comments, so you'll be dealing directly with me through our forum. So once again, thank you for your support.